the most incredible come-from-behind win in Jazz history.
Congratulations, Karl Malone, 1996-97 NBA Most Valuable Player.
Uh-oh. Stockton, open three. John Stockton sends the Utah Jazz to the NBA Finals.
The Utah Jazz start the 1996-97 season with a new logo, new uniforms, and a new floor. But one of those doesn't last very long.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, there's no way that the floor is playable tonight. And for the safety of players in our league, we feel like it's necessary to cancel the game.
So the old floor returns to its familiar setting, and the Jazz start to roll. The team takes a three-game winning streak into L.A. to meet the Lakers and Hollywood's newest and biggest star. But it's Karl Malone who takes center stage, scoring 20 points in the third quarter to lead the rout. The next night at home, the Warriors appear to have the Jazz on the ropes. But with time running out, the mailman delivers again.
Fires it up top to Karl Malone. He fires for 20. Yes! We go to overtime!
The Jazz pull away in overtime, and the streak is at 5. Just in time to welcome the world champs and their unblemished 12-0 record.
Incredible Michael Jordan.
Like a couple of prize fighters, the teams trade punches. The Jazz matching Jordan's incredible display with depth and versatility.
On the nose to tank.
In the end, it's the Jazz who are still standing as they beat the Bulls 105-100. 2 games later, the streak appears to be all but gone as the lowly Denver Nuggets come out unconscious in the Delta Center.
Bryant's tipped the three. Yes!
Ooh, my goodness!
Finding themselves down by 34 points at the break, the Jazz are left shaking their heads.
We were shell-shocked. Granted, we didn't play good defense, but I was calm and said, even if they went through a shooting drill with nobody on them, that's about what they'd probably shoot.
But NBA history begins to unfold in the second half.
Low to the mailman, turn in, score! Karl Malone! The Jazz are rolling!
I start believing it when we cut it from a 36 down to like 18. And you can start seeing the look in their face. They didn't want to take those shots, but they were still shooting the three. Then all of a sudden, we cut it down to 13.
Stockton holds, left corner to Horney, open shot, good! Hornacek!
We cut it down to 9.
Stockton drive the alley, underneath the Morris, reverse slam dunk! Stockton to Morris!
Then we cut it down to 8 and then 4.
Now to Stockton, Jazz run, Stockton to the middle, to Shannon Anderson, hammered up, the young rookie! Bring it in for the right side.
And I was like, okay.
Hornacek holding to Stockton. Stockton, 12 seconds to Karl Malone. Down Russell, climbed up, down Russell. Unbelievable.
The historic win keeps the Jazz steaming into December. And the streak peaks at 15. A new franchise record.
Bounce right side. He'll put up a three-pointer. This one no good. Rebound, Gugliotta.
The rest of December turns a bit frosty, though, as the Jazz hit the road and come away with just 2 wins in 5 tries. January gets even colder. Another road trip yields just 1 victory. And coach Jerry Sloan is searching for ways to right the ship. But led by the veterans, the Jazz win 7 of 8 heading into the All-Star break, including another big win in Seattle. In February, perennial All-Stars John Stockton and Karl Malone make their annual trek to the NBA's midseason festivities. But this year, there's more than the game to remember. The future Hall of Famers are honored as 2 of the NBA's 50 greatest players.
From the Utah Jazz, number 12, John Stockton. From the Utah Jazz, number 32, the mailman, Karl Malone. Ladies and gentlemen, let us salute together the greatest NBA players of all time.
Without a doubt, that was the highlight of any All-Star game I had. Being around those guys and talking to those guys, it was tremendous. It was great. It's something that I'll never forget for a long time.
Back from the break, the Jazz pick up right where they left off.
Wesley, drive the middle. Pulled it up. Rejected by Antoine. Stockton's got it. Jazz run to the mailman. To Brian Russell. Slammed down. Beautiful fast break. And the Jazz have this one in the refrigerator.
Winning 8 of 9 to close out the month. In March, the Jazz machine kicks into high gear, going a perfect 4-for-4, heading into their longest road trip of the year. It's also their most successful, as Utah wins 6 of 7 on the Eastern swing, effectively taking control of the Western Conference race. In the midst of it all, the mailman delivers the 25,000th point of his career.
Here it is! Mailman slammed up! 25,000 career points for Karl Malone. What a beautiful hammer dunk coming right down the lane.
But the personal achievements take a backseat to the winning. The Jazz go 15-1 in March, the best month in team history. The roll continues into April, and the winning streak reaches 15 with back-to-back wins over LA and Houston. Utah's regular season record of 64-18 is the best in franchise history. And the Jazz lay claim to their fourth Midwest Division crown. But all eyes are on a much bigger prize. In the first round of the playoffs, the Jazz record the first series sweep in team history, making short work of the Los Angeles Clippers.
Back to Stock, he's underneath, back here, flipped it up, what a move, scoring the bucket.
In the second round, they continue their dominance over the city of Los Angeles as they whip Shaq and the Lakers in game one before dogging them with a pair of free throws in game two.
Here we go, he's at the line, the big dog. First one. Good! Dead center! Antoine Carr!
Game 3 is a forgettable performance at the Forum, but in Game 4, a classical Jazz road effort more than makes up for it. Karl Malone unloads 42 points on the Lakers, and Brian Russell goes off for a career-high 29 as the Jazz leave Tinseltown up 3-1. Back at home, the Jazz work overtime to finish it off. The win sends L.A. packing and Utah to the Western Conference Finals for the fourth time in 6 years.
It's all over. Jazz knocked the Lakers out 4-1. What a win.
In mid-May, the NBA bestows its highest individual honor upon a certain mailman from Utah.
But congratulations, Karl Malone, 1996-97 NBA Most Valuable Player.
Facing their old playoff nemesis, the Jazz ripped the Rockets in games 1 and 2 at the Delta Center. In Houston, however, Eddie Johnson helps the Rockets hold serve, and the series is tied heading back to Salt Lake. In game 5, the mailman delivers a victory with a barrage of jumpers that leaves the Rockets reeling and puts the Jazz one win away from the NBA Finals. For most of Game 6, the Rockets are in control. But trailing by 10 in the closing minutes, John Stockton takes over, scoring Utah's last 13 points, including the game winner.
Russell will inbound at half court. Stockton, open three. Hit! John Stockton sends the Utah Jazz to the NBA Finals.
We have never seen this kind of emotion from Stockton and Malone, and finally, their day has come.
The Utah Jazz says, yes, we are moving on with a 4-2 victory over the Houston Rockets.
I feel like everybody did the right thing. The ball, Brian made a great pass to me, got it to me quickly, and Just got rid of it. So I'm just thrilled it went in.
Finals fever hits Salt Lake before the team even arrives home. 15,000 fans show up at 3 in the morning to welcome the Western Conference champs. Jazz blow into the Windy City looking to steal game one. And for most of four quarters, they do everything it takes to do so.
Off the pick and roll.
But in the end, Michael Jordan steals it back for the Bulls.
We're down to two, now to one. Here's Jordan. Yes! It is all over.
Another loss in game two has Chicagoans thinking sweet. But Jazz fans have other plans.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Back in the Delta Center, and back in front of a raucous home crowd, the mailman goes off in game three, scoring 37 points. The bench comes up big as well, as the Jazz open up a huge lead in the second quarter. By the time the Bulls knew what hit them, it's 61-45 Jazz at halftime. The onslaught continues in the second half as the Jazz run away with their first finals victory.
We didn't have any type of intensity in tonight's game. We didn't stand up and challenge them in any way, and they pretty much kicked our butt the first half.
We didn't come into this thing to just win one game. Again, they're a great team. I don't want to take anything away from that, but I don't think anybody on our team is going to be happy with just one win.
In game four, the Jazz find themselves trailing by five with just over 2 minutes to play. But just as he did in Houston, John Stockton takes matters into his own hands, leading Utah to victory with one shot. One steal. And one picture perfect pass.
Stockton fires down on the layup.
To me, that's a pass there that I'll remember. Out of all the great ones he's made, I'll remember this one right here probably for the rest of my career because it had to be the perfect pass.
John Stockton, you work on this pass your whole life.
With the series now even at two games apiece, the world championship is literally up for grabs. The Jazz come out smoking, and it looks like a blowout in the making. Ryan Russell finishes the half in style as he breaks away. But Michael Jordan single-handedly brings the Bulls back. And in the final minute, he again delivers the big blow. So it's back to Chicago for game six. And with their backs against the wall, the Jazz respond, taking control of the game behind Brian Russell's bombs. But once again, Jordan would do in the Jazz. Not with a shot, but a pass.
Steve Kerr, reminiscent of John Paxson in 93.
Scottie Pippen steals the Jazz' last chance, bringing the dream season to a bittersweet end.
Karl Malone goes by and congratulates Phil Jackson. An emotional moment there, very tough and disappointing.
Still, the team is welcomed home like champions.
And
You guys gave us the energy to do what we was capable of doing this year, but we kind of got a feel of that. So hopefully next year we'll do a better job. And like I said,
we'll do a better job.
I can't think of a better place I want to be at. I love you guys. Thank you.
I love you guys.
64 regular season wins. The NBA Finals. The MVP. Proof positive that this is indeed a most valuable season.